In this illustration, we'll discuss about the curvature of a trajectory. Here we are given that a particle moves in a plane in xy coordinate system with velocity vector given as ai cap plus bx j cap. And at t equals to 0, it starts from 0, 0. And here we are required to find the radius of curvature of particle's trajectory as a function of x. So here in solution, we can see the x component of velocity of particle vx is given as a, which can be written as dx by dt. So this is our first equation. And the y component of velocity dy by dt, here we can write as vy, which is bx. Say this is the second equation. Here if we divide the two equations 1 by 2, you can see this will give us dx over dy is equals to a by bx. And on further simplifying, here you can see the value of dy we are getting is b by ax dx. If we integrate this expression at x equals to 0, y was also 0 because we are given that particle starts from 0, 0, and at the position x, it attains a position y in y coordinate axis. So on integrating this, we are getting y is equals to bx square by 2a. So this is the equation of trajectory of the particle if it is moving according to this velocity. And from here we can calculate the slope of this curve, which is dy by dx. That is equals to bx by a, and if we further differentiate it, d square y by dx square, the curvature can be given as b by a. And using this, here we can calculate the radius of curvature of the trajectory, which can be given as 1 plus dy by dx whole square to power 3 by 2 divided by d square y by dx square magnitude. On substituting the values, the value of radius of curvature we are getting is 1 plus b square x square by a square whole power 3 by 2 divided by this derivative is b by a. So this can be written as a by b multiplied by 1 plus b square x square by a square to whole power 3 by 2. That is the final result of this problem.